people your the cell phones, devices in silence, and I know that he's going to say something.
Yes, I won't. Thank you so much. Welcome to my living room. This is my house. We built this place to have concerts and events in it, and that's what we do. And for example, tonight there's a string quartet performing here. Now, the room that you hear right now is this room, but when I go back in there, you're going to hear, for the whole concert, you're going to hear a place called, it's the Chapelle des Jésuites. So it's a small church in Quebec City. It's a historic church. It's probably 300 years old or so. So that's the place we're going to be. Now, this is thanks to the ACS system. There's 27 speakers, 12 microphones. There's like all kinds of systems in the mechanical room back there. And this is the only system like that in Florida. And it's the only one of that company. It's a Dutch company called ACS, and it's the only one from that company south of Harvard. And so there's only three or four in the US. So it's we're very, very lucky that they chose this room to use as a demo space for themselves.
What's the kind of sound that it is again, so I can translate to them?
So it's an active acoustic control system.
Okay, and that, what's the church called?
The place is called Chapelle des Jésuites.
Okay, Jésuites. Where is that?
That's in Quebec City.
In Quebec, okay, yeah. So, para los que no entienden en inglés, este es el único sitio en el mundo, ahora mismo hay solamente como dos o tres lugares que tienen un sistema de sonido que it resembles el sonido, imita el sonido exacto de una capilla que hay en Quebec, Canadá. Cuando se comienza el concierto, lo que ustedes van a escuchar, la manera en que lo van a escuchar es ese surrounded sound, which is, I think, is amazing.
It makes it very easy to sing. So anyways, the art that you see is by Everett Struhl, and I want to tell the performers, please remind you to kind of stand in this area when you're singing, and when you're done, please take your time and bow like deliberately and like very, so that your parents can have time to take a nice picture of you while you're bowing. I am filming all of this. You don't need to film. It's streaming right now. The stream will stay there. And then also I'm recording it, and I will give a video link to Arlene when I'm finished. Any questions? Preguntas? Yo entiendo un poquito español. Hablo un poquito.
Very good.
Disculpe, mi español está muy mal.
Just give him an applause. So, did everybody understand what he said?
Yes.
Okay, so I've been doing our recitals here for, I believe, 4 years?
Five
years now? Wow, that's a long time. And I just love this place. Please support this place. This is about the only few places that there are. I think it's the only one around this area. And it's just such an amazing work that what this family has been doing. I've worked with Benoit's wife. We've worked in like in opera ensembles, choirs, just a pianist. This is an amazing family. And what they've been doing here is remarkable. So look up on their page, their activities. They have amazing concerts here, very affordable, extremely affordable, and you see how beautiful this place is, okay? Now, just I wanted to say a few words. This is a very special recital for me personally, because I've seen so many things happening throughout the years with some of my students, and this year I have some students whom I've seen kind of like grow up throughout my singing studio. And we have one in particular today with us who just started her first year of college. I have like three who started their first year of college actually, and they went towards the performing arts, musical theater and music production. One of them was here last year, but this year we have another one. You'll know who she is. And I am so very proud because she happens to be my oldest student here in Central Florida. So I basically opened up my studio with her.
Don't cry.
No, I will cry. And so it is very remarkable. I just want to read something really quick. I am informal like this. You know me. It says, we don't present our voices to the audience, we resonate our souls. This is a quote from Thomas Hampson. And I want you all to know that these kids today are resonating their souls. This is not a competition. This is just a showcase of the things that they've been working on. And I was talking to a friend yesterday. He's actually the other pianist here today with us. And he's an educator as well. And me as an educator, I resonated with his words because he said that we as educators, especially music educators, especially when we work one-on-one with the students, we are more than singing teachers, piano teachers, whatnot. We are mentors. We become mentors. We become the mom, the dad. In certain cases, I have children here. I have like, I don't know how many children I have. And really, you get to make such a connection with these wonderful souls that it just, you know, you feel like you really gave birth to a soul through music teaching. And so that is the importance that music has in their lives. And I want to thank all the parents and families who have been supporting the students throughout for years. For example, like that one student who has been with me, I've seen her mom running up and down. It's the craziness of rehearsals and all of that, but all of that pays off. And even if you didn't do it professionally, it is just an enrichment. It's a spiritual enrichment as well as an emotional and mental enrichment that music brings to our lives. So keep on doing it. Thank you so much and enjoy the show. Yes.
Thank you. Turn your thoughts away from cold, unfeeling light, and listen to the music of the night. Close your eyes and surrender to your darkest dreams. Purge your thoughts of the life you thank you.
students, they put together their own little scene for their song. So they're using either a prop or their clothes to represent what they're singing about, the play that they're singing about.
There it goes again. The moment's gone, and I'm too lame to speak. Another wasted opportunity. Always waiting for something to happen, but nothing's gonna happen. Not for me. I'm a girl, for your information, forever in this situation, waiting and hoping he'll notice how I'm feeling. But every time I get him near, I fade away, I disappear. That's me, never getting hurt. He just smiles and walks away like I never said a word.
Sparkle on the grass, but my melody can never be replaced.
Performing times, you know?
Bring it forward.
Okay,
please.
Good. Thank you so much.
Oh,
having fun. That's all about it, yeah? I love you.
Thank you. Speaking of the times before the war.
next song. You know, we have fun at the studio. And I have lots of fun with Fabiola. She has such a personality. And so sometimes, you know, part of my singing teaching is just instilling them the love for improvisation and you know, different styles of music. And sometimes they bring music that they want to do and sing. And so this is one of those songs that she said, we need to sing this. And just as she was singing, I started doing some duets with her. And she's like, we need to do this together. So we've been trying to do this together for like 2 years,
practicing every 2 months.
So finally. Encouraging our students. And this one last song, I saved it for that one student that I talked about before. And that is Alondra Trinidad Colón. I am so honored to have such an amazing student as my, or I don't want to say student, but human being, because she's not only talented as a student, but she's an amazing human being. And just like any other students that have gone through my studio and have pursued professional careers in music, Alondra is one of them. And you know, with this whole COVID situation, all of you, all of my students here, I have to give a big round of applause. So all of you have managed to complete programs online, singing online, dancing online, and this lady right here, she just completed her first year in college in the Philadelphia School of Performing Arts, right?
Point Park University.
Point Park University, thank you so much. You see, it's a lot of schools. She just completed her first year, and the reason, like I told you, why it is so remarkable, this recital, I know if she'll have another recital with us, she's going to now to Philadelphia. She's going to be very committed, so be on the lookout, because this lady here, she's going to kill it. And you know, just because she was one of my first students when I first started teaching in Central Florida. So thank you so much, and we'll have a pizza party. Please don't, at the end, don't go, just the students, come up here so we can take a picture and quickly run out of the venue, and whatever we have to talk, we'll talk outside, okay? All right, thank you. And we're live, so please. Something happens, we'll just start over. Thank you. want to give a round of applause to the two pianists, Lynn Pagini and Danny. Don't leave because I want to take a picture with you too. So come over here, all the students. Writing, singing writing journal. Do you remember how I've told you?